everybody. Welcome back to the channel. I've had a problem over the last couple of weeks or so, maybe three, where the cruise control system would come on, but the cruise control wouldn't set at a speed and maintain it, and then the little indicator light wouldn't come on at all. So that's been going on for a couple of weeks, and then I had picked up a trailer for my tiny house yesterday, and the electric brakes for the trailer would come on and stay on and lock up. I had to turn them all the way down to the lowest setting so the brakes wouldn't come on in the trailer so I could get the trailer home. So not having cruise control was an inconvenience, but the brakes needed to work on the trailer. They will need to work on the trailer. So I got on a Googleator, and figured it out. But let me just show you what was going on with the cruise control. So typical cruise control right here on this truck is what it looks like. So this button here, you push it and that light comes on, and it would always come on. That indicates that the cruise control system is on and activated and ready to work, right? And so you would then get to the speed that you want to be at, and you hit the cruise control button, or you hit the set button right there, and the little green light comes on, little speedometer indicator with an arrow, meaning, yeah, we're going to maintain the speed that you're currently going, right? Typical cruise control stuff. So what would happen is I would, you know, get into traffic, or for whatever reason have to slow down, and I'd hit the brake, and, you know, cruising down because the foot's on the floor, right? Cruise control's on, I tap the brake, and then get in the gas, get around traffic, get back up to my speed and find a button again and hit it, and hey, no cruise control, it wouldn't work. So like I said, when I picked up the trailer yesterday, the trailer brakes were staying on, and every once in a while, and you know, every once in a while then I could get cruise control back, it would work. But you know, no matter how many times I hit that button, they wouldn't come on. It just randomly would come back. And it was sort of the same with the trailer brakes. It seems like they'd work, and then all of a sudden, they would be on, and they just stay on. So had to get that fixed. Trailer brakes are important when you're towing a trailer, especially when your tiny house is on a trailer, and you want to live. So hit the old Googleator and typed in my truck. I don't think I said that yet. The 2010 Chevy Silverado extended cab LZ. Z71 four-wheel drive package with tow package, whatever. That's probably not as important as the body style in general is a 2010, and I had a 2008. It was the same body style, so I don't know if they've actually even changed body styles yet. And other Chevy vehicles, like you know, like the half ton and the three-quarter ton, it might be applicable to, as well as the Avalanche, the Chevy Avalanche. So I type in my vehicle information into the Googleator and say cruise control not working, and you know, do a few searches and stuff, and find this one forum, this one Chevy forum, and guy's having pretty much the same problem with his cruise control as he described to me, as I described to you. And he goes through and says what his deal is. People respond back and forth, and I just keep scrolling down because hey, it's right on target. I haven't seen like the quick fix yet. So somebody with a 2008 Chevy Avalanche said, hey, I'm having the same problem, and in fact, my cruise control was acting up. He goes, what I found is it was the switch on the brake pedal would get stuck, right? So there's a switch on the brake pedal. When you push the brakes down, that switch activates or closes or opens or whatever it does, and tells the truck that the brakes are being depressed and turns on the stop lights or the tail lights. Turns on the, turns off the cruise control, activates the brake controller, does whatever it's supposed to do, right? He goes, so that switch was getting stuck when I pressed the brake pedal down. So what I could do to fix it temporarily is I just take my foot and I would tap the side of the brake pedal, and then I would hit my cruise control button, which I'm about ready to do. And there you go. The cruise control comes back on. So he said that was what his issue was that button, or the switch on the brake pedal, and that all he had to do to replace it was get a new switch, which was fairly inexpensive. He didn't say how much it was, and he gave the part number. I'll try and find that part number again and put it down in the description. And then all it took was a 10 millimeter wrench and a screwdriver to pop a clip open and pull the switch out, and he's put the new one in. He said he was good to go. So Benzai was able to tap that brake pedal with my foot and fix the problem. I'm betting it's the that switch on the brake pedal that's giving me problems. So that's it. 5 minutes. I hope that solved your problem, and now you're ready to go out to your truck and get in it and tap the brake pedal and see if it fixes your problem. And I hope it does. When I get the switch, which it might be a couple of days, I'll try and do a video of swapping that switch in and post it for you guys to take a look at too. All right, safe driving. Take care.